Good morning all, myself Ramya. I'm going to explain what is Peterson solution. In the previous video we have seen what is synchronization, why we need synchronization, what are the requirements for critical section problem. And we know synchronization is, why we need synchronization is, if you are not applying synchronization, there is a chance to get a inconsistent output. Suppose there are more than one process to access the resource variable. If you are not applying synchronization, you may get different output. For the example, for the count variable, actual output of count variable is 5, but we may get either 6, 5 or 4. To avoid that, we have to apply the synchronization, and there are different algorithms for synchronization. In this particular video, we are going to see Peterson solution. And subject code is 18 CS 43, and syllabus is synchronization, critical section problem, Peterson solution, synchronization hardware, SEMAFOR, classical problems of synchronization and monitors. Prerequisites for this particular topic is knowledge about process and process scheduling. Objective is Peterson solution and synchronization mechanism. There are two types of synchronization mechanism: mutual exclusion with busy wait, mutual exclusion without busy wait. With busy wait is also known as spin code. Mutual exclusion without busy wait is also known as blocking mechanism. These two classification provide solution for software level and hardware level. And there are different types of algorithms and a synchronization mechanism. Those are disabling interrupt, lock variable, strict alternate, Peterson solution, TSL instruction, sleep and wake up, SEMAFOR and monitor. And as per your syllabus, we are going to see Peterson solution, TSL instruction, SEMAFOR and monitors. Out of these algorithms, disabling interrupt, lock variable, strict alternate, Peterson solution, TSL instruction are coming under mutual exclusion with busy wait. Sleep and wake up, SEMAFOR, monitors are coming under mutual exclusion without busy wait. Peterson solution. Peterson solution is a software solution and it is coming under mutual exclusion with a busy wait, and it is applicable for only for two process solution. It cannot be applied for many process solution. And this algorithm require two variables. Those two variables are turned integer variable and boolean flag 2. It is a array variable of size 2. Why size 2? Means it is applicable only for two process solution, two process. And 10 indicate whom 10 is next. 10 is equal to I means process I, there are two process P and PJ. 10 is equal to I means PI process is going to enter the critical section next. 10 is equal to J means PJ process is going to enter the critical section next. And flag of do, flag of I is equal to true means ith process is ready to go to critical section. Flag of J is equal to true means jth process is ready to go to critical section. This is the algorithm for process PI. The same way we have algorithm for process PJ also. In here, the first box indicate entry section, second box indicate exit section. To go to critical section, process must satisfy entry section. So there are two process PI and PJ, both are trying to go to critical section. Which process satisfy entry section first, it can go to critical section. The same time another process is going to wait outside the critical section. They're waiting for their chance. So flag of I is equal to true means PI is ready to go to critical section. Turn of J is equal to means is jth process turn to go to critical section. And next is a while loop. Inside while loop there are two conditions. If we satisfy these two condition, PI cannot go to critical section. Those two conditions are flag of J. Flag of J indicate flag of J is equal to true. Flag of J is equal to true means jth process is ready to go to critical section. Turn is equal to J means its jth process turn. So these two conditions satisfy means PI cannot go to critical section. It has to wait in the outside. That indicate PJ is already there in the critical section. And so when PI can go to critical section, if any one condition fails, that indicate either flag of J is equal to false or turn is equal to I. If any one condition fails, PI can go to critical section. Otherwise PI has to wait. That is first box. Second box is about exit section. Once PI come out from the critical section, it has to make flag of I is equal to false. That indicate it is not ready to go to critical section again. This is the algorithm for process PI. And Peterson solution satisfy mutual exclusion, progress requirement, bounded waiting. What is mutual exclusion? If PI is already ready PA is already there in the critical section, PJ cannot go to critical section. That indicates at the same time, two processes cannot be there in the critical section. At a time, only one process can be there in the critical section. Peterson solution is preserving the mutual exclusion. Progress requirement satisfied. What is progress requirement? There are two processes, PA and PJ. PA is ready to go to critical section. PJ is already done with their critical section. Then PJ should not restrict PA go to the critical section. That is progress requirement. Boundary waiting also met here. What is boundary waiting? It should not be indefinite wait for a process to go to critical section. All these three conditions satisfied by Peterson solution. And the coming slides, we are going to see how Peterson solution is satisfying these three conditions. First one is mutual exclusion. Mutual exclusion is preserved here. How mutual exclusion is preserved? PA can enter the critical section only if either flag of J is equal to false or 10 is equal to I. We know 10 is a variable. It can take either I or J. It cannot take both together, right? So, if 10 is equal to J, J is 10. 10 is equal to I, it's I to 10. So, there are two conditions. Either flag of J is equal to false. Suppose flag of J is equal to false in the while condition. Then PA can go inside, right? So flag of J is equal to false means J cannot go inside. Only I cannot go. I can go. Or suppose 10 is equal to I. 10 cannot be I and J together. So J cannot be go. So using those two condition, either PA can go inside or J can go inside. It is not possible to go PA and PJ together inside. So mutual exclusion is preserved. And next are progress or bounding waits requirement. Progress is seen after coming from critical section, PA will make flag of I is equal to false. So that indicates PA is not ready to go to critical section. It is coming out from the critical section, right? So it is not restricting PJ to go to critical section. It is already, the PA is already done with the critical section. They made their flag of I is equal to false. That indicates PA is not going to restrict PJ after coming from critical section. PA is not going to restrict PJ to go to critical section. So PJ also, progress also satisfied. Next one is bounded waiting. If PJ reset flag of J is equal to true, it must also set 10 to I. The first two statements, see, flag of I is equal to true, 10 is equal to J, right? Like that in the jth process, flag of J is equal to true, it must also set 10 to I. Thus, since PI does not change the value of variable 10 while executing the while statement, PI will enter the critical section after at most one entry by PJ. So, it is alternate 10. First PI will go, then PJ, or PJ will go, then PA. It is alternate 10. All conditions are satisfied here. So, in this video, we discussed about Peterson solution. Peterson solution is a software solution to satisfy the process synchronization, and it is applicable. The important point is it is applicable only for two process solution. The two variables are 10 variable and flag variable. 10 indicate whom 10 is to go to inside. Flag indicate which the particular process is ready to go to critical section or not. And this Peterson solution satisfied with our three conditions. First one is mutual exclusion, progress and bounded waiting. I hope all of you understood Peterson solution. And the next video we are going to see hardware solutions, test and set, CMOS. Thank you.